Say I won't.
Why y'all scared to be different?
Say I won't.
Why y'all scared to be different?
Say I won't.
We them outsiders, that's just how we live it.
So today's a special day, and the reason for that is because my dad has finally given me the pink slip to the Supra. So as a lot of you guys may know, on June 1st, I recently graduated from high school. And so because of that, obviously, you know, my parents are proud of me and all that. My parents decided to give me a gift, and the gift that they gave me was the Toyota Supra. So my dad signed the pink slip and he handed it over to me and he said the car is yours now. So once again, I'm out here in the morning to transfer the ownership of this car over to my name now, so it will officially be mine. So we're gonna go ahead and do that really quickly. We have another project that we're gonna be working on today, which is gonna be installing the front speakers for the car itself because they're blown. So once we finish up here, I'm gonna head home and do that. I'm gonna run you guys just straight through it on how to do it, and we'll see what the difference sounds like. You bet your revenue, thinking you'll stop me, no, never not letting you. You must be high on that medical, thinking I won't, better know better, know that I bet I do, yeah. Kill him, ooh. So about after an hour waiting at the DMV, your boy is finally the owner of the Toyota Supra. I'm excited, but at the same time, like, I'm kind of not. I know my parents are going to make me start, you know, paying for everything that has to do with the car. But hey, it's part of life, and I'm honestly, like, I'm fine with it, because I'm going to be working soon. So, here we go. Project Toyota Supra. And so now I'm home, and so really quickly we're just gonna get started. I bought some Boss audio 4-inch speakers from Fry's, and I'll be installing those as replacements for the OEM ones because the OEM ones are, you know, busted. So let's get these things done. Boys covered in cover girls like mascara. I don't need to keep a gun in a mask ever. I still make them put their hands up. Ask Derek, my road manager, damage all of you amateurs sneaking up on a tour bus with a demo to handle us. When I was younger, I just wanted a chain. Now a chain of events has afforded a change. Yeah. See, I've been a rebel since back in the day. I don't follow the people. I follow the leader through valleys and shadows of death and I'm fearing no evil. We got all these screws. All of them out.
At the bottom, four of them.
And then you get the handlebar screw out, and then once you do that, you pretty much lift it. On the passenger side, there's also one little screw right there. If you guys can see, it's right there, and you gotta make sure to take that one out before you can actually take the whole piece out. Otherwise, you could jeopardize ripping the whole side.
Say I won't.
We them outsiders, that's just how we live it.
Say I won't.
And I bet I will. You can
say I won't.
Little wires right here that are connected to the controllers when it comes to the windows, all that stuff. And then got these old speakers right here. These are factory. So this is the old speaker, just right here. There's like a wire running all the way down to this little plug-in. So it just comes into the plug-in. Then it goes through two wires, just right there. So we're gonna go ahead and replace this and put in a new speaker. So these are the new little guys. These are the brand new little speakers. And as you guys can see, this one is a three bracket, so it has 3 points. And this one has four. So I'm gonna have to come up with like some type of adapter to fit it into the little casing, because I'm probably gonna keep that just so it runs a bit easier. If I ever took a loss, I learned a lesson. So one of the only issues that I'm running into is that I already took out the screws, but these guys are glued onto this. So I'm gonna have to like figure out a way to pry it open. I'm probably gonna get like a little knife or something, start cutting away at the glue, and then start just prying it apart so that I can go ahead and just put in the newer one. Around most of it, and that's the little bit you gotta peel off. Just like that. happy about it. We gotta splice these two wires. So what I did was fabricated two of these little guys, and I put them together, and then I put a screw in the middle to these guys because they fit really nicely. And then after that, I put a little type of Velcro spongy type thing. It's like this. So I put one of the nails through here, just like that. And then I got the bracket, put it just like that, lay it over. Another bracket, boom, boom, extended it. And then just to finish it off, taped it all together. So now it doesn't move. So I should hold it in place. Older speakers, everything else is buttoned up. Just gotta clean the car a little bit. Should be good. So the same that was done to one side, obviously you do on the other side. I'm only changing the front two because the front two were the only ones that were blown, so the ones in the back are fine. I do plan to put a full sound system into this car at some point, but you know, right now just going with a little bit of the cheaper route, just because it's a little easier to go ahead and do. And so the speakers are in. I'm kind of excited to hear it. So both of them are in, both sides. It's just time to put them to the test, I guess. So the video itself doesn't really give it as much justice, but the speakers definitely sound way better than they did before, because last time they would like crack and they'd make all these noises, right? Because they were blown. Obviously, they were blown speakers. Once again, thank you. Shout out to my friend Henson, who was able to hook it up down at Fry's. Bro, you're the boy. Thank you so much. I can finally, you know, cruise to like some good music and not blown speakers anymore. So, well, that's going to be cool. That'll be fun. What you got in here, Jesse?
What you want to know?
Type R,
76 mil, 700, sleeper,
stock interior, look at it.
It's not a K-Series.
Quickly, right before we go and hit the shop and change Dominic's LEDs, we came to Bamboo really quick. My boy Ricky,
what?
My boy Jesse, and my homie Alex with the fastest Teggy in Sunnyvale. Go ahead and hit him up if you're trying to race. We head over to the shop. Came to pick up one last person. He's a pretty cool guy. Not exactly part of ValeeMeetz, but I feel like he's cool enough to be on the vlog. Meet Itza, guys. Back here at Car Mods to try to find out what's going on with Dominic's dash, because his dash doesn't turn on. So far, no luck. Thought it was the fuse, but it's not the fuse. And so we're just going to keep on working on the dash, see what's going on. I have to put Dominic's dash back on because he doesn't know how to do it. And Dominic likes other people to work on his car because he doesn't know how to work on cars. So. Huh, Dominic?
Yeah.
All right, Dominic. Show me your LEDs real quick, bro. What do you think?
It's fucking dope.
So just to end this vlog, we're gonna end it with Uriel detailing this car. It's Dominic's Subaru. We're gonna finish it just that, because I mean there's nothing really else. Today was a good successful day. We were able to hit Car Mods today and go ahead and get LEDs, finish the LEDs on the Supra, get some LEDs for the Subaru, and Supra's mine now. So stay up, stay tuned. New meet is coming soon. Till next time. She said she need more of my love and affection. Cause lately I've
been working harder.